Perhaps the most famous ship to ever take on the load of coal there was the battleship Maine. Unfortunately, though, that was the Maine's last load of coal. For after Key West, she sailed to Havana, Cuba. While in Havana Harbor, she mysteriously exploded. No group organization ever took credit for that explosion, but it is said to have been the catalyst to the Spanish-American War. And where we see this on a cable crossing, do not anchor. That is another Old Navy gear. In fact, you can tell by its very exciting name, Pier B. Mallory Square, Pier A, Pier B, and the Navy Outer Mole, which we'll be passing in a moment, are all sites used by cruise ships. We don't have any in town today, but it's not uncommon for us to see two, three, and sometimes even four cruise ships here in Key West Harbor. We do my host ride around 500 cruise ship boardings every year. Looking up and back from here, you'll see that red brick building with a bright red roof. That is Old Navy 1. It was built in 1891 as our government center, as our courthouse, and the office offices. Over the years, though, part of the business is missing the name. As a concern, we have got a lot of money in the building. Now, they're in the start of the museum. What it was built, though, is what you can manage to get coming together. Material, they had to find somewhere to put it all, so they ended up piling some of it onto three shallow sandbars. It is the second largest masonry structure in the world, following the Great Wall of China. Construction on that fort was begun prior to the Civil War. Oddly enough, though, it's kind of changed since, and it's held by the Great War. After his retirement, thank you.
Nên là sáng sáu đi nó là thế.